Hangin' with Hester.
Third and goal at the 2.5. Flynn under center. Hester straight ahead. He is in for the score!
Hangin' with Hester with Jacob Hester. Wall-to-wall football.
I have not seen a gutsier performance by a Tiger running back maybe ever.
Now, Hangin' with Hester with Jacob Hester on 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Yo.
Yo.
I'm not doing the yo.
Yo.
There's no yo. We don't, that's Jacob's thing.
Well, sometimes you come up with a whoa. Whoa.
How about a hey?
Hey.
Hey.
All right, welcome everybody. Ronnie Rantz, Richard Dickson here filling in for Jacob Hester, who has Monday off. He'll be back here tomorrow, right? He'll be back here tomorrow.
Yeah, he schemed it. He did the
long weekend. It's
good.
Goes well
into
done.
July.
Well played.
Yeah, we get July 3rd off, so he's just like basically not coming.
Yeah, veteran move, veteran move.
Yep.
So hang with Hester, presented by Richard's Honda, as we are here in studio. Hope everybody had a wonderful weekend. 4th of July on the horizon at the end of the week. Are you a fireworks guy, Richard? Are you going to be popping the fireworks?
Yeah, you know, we usually go back to my parents' house on the beach, mm-hmm. and you can see the fireworks shows from Gulfport to Pascagoula, and then we usually have some of our own to light off.
Yeah, my folks have a condo right there next to Floribama, and they said it's the best fireworks show in the world.
Oh, it must be nice, you too.
They literally watch the fireworks at Floribama, and then Perdido's side of the beach, they actually have their own fireworks, and all the people out on, I mean, it's pretty unbelievable. They go for two, 3 hours
yeah.
in this fireworks show.
When the weather's nice, you can take the boat out a little bit, about halfway to Horn Island, and you can really catch every Gulf Coast town doing their fireworks show. You get to see them all, and it's usually pretty fun.
Lloyd, are you going to be at Brewley at Buzzy Heidel's house for the fireworks show?
Oh, yeah, you know it. We're going to have the crawfish boil that I never get invited to, so I'm just going to pop one by. I know he's doing it.
And the golf round and everything. Well, look, we'll talk a little sports here today. On Hang with Hester, we'll jump around to a bunch of different topics. Those folks that tune in to Sports Shorts right here on ESPN Radio on Saturday mornings know it's a lot of sports, a lot of shorts, a little bit of sports, but we'll try to flip that. We'll try to flip that today and take it a little bit more seriously. But as far as the news of the day, and it's not a surprise, we've been knowing about this for a while, but like it's official, is that Cam Newton has agreed to play with the Patriots for a year, signed a 1-year deal, making just over $1 million guaranteed. Now, his deal could jump to about 7.5, but he was released by the Panthers back on March the 24th. Cam Newton agrees to play with the Patriots. And you've got two guys from the NFC South last year that were starting quarterbacks, Jameis Winston and Cam Newton, that have been faces of that league for the last 5 years. I mean, Cam Newton even longer. Guy went to a Super Bowl. But, I mean, these were guys that probably in – Cam Newton and Jameis Winston before last season would have been considered top 15 quarterbacks in the NFL. Probably even considered franchise quarterbacks for both teams. I mean, that's fair to say. I mean, Cam Newton's a franchise quarterback for the Panthers. Who's going to be in their Hall of Fame and former MVP. Jameis Winston threw 5,000 yards, 30 touchdowns. We know the interceptions. But the point is, in a year's time, both of them have now taken, you know, Winston a backup role.
Yeah.
Clearly a backup role. He's not going to win the job in New Orleans over Drew Brees. Now, who knows what happens with Cam? That's more of a possibility. But, I mean, it's amazing how things have changed for both of them.
Well, it changes fast, and if you're really looking at it, I think Winston's in a better position. He's a guy that can go sit behind Drew Brees. He's still, 26, 27 years old. He's got a lot of playing days left in his career, and he's going to take a step back and learn. Whereas Cam signing a 1-year deal with the Patriots, to me, it's like it's a prove-it year. You're going to go out and take a small contract, and you're going to prove that you're still a top-valued quarterback. But if things don't work out well for him, I don't know where his next spot is. I think he's actually losing money, because if he doesn't have a great year, then who wants to sign him to big money? I mean, he's doing a 1-year deal, and he's been hurt. He's battled injuries the last couple of years. This is going to be a huge year for Cam.
It's a weird fit, right? Because Cam Newton's been an outspoken guy. If you know about Cam Newton, you know he's famous for his press conferences where, one, he dresses to the nines, okay? I mean, he comes up with some flamboyant stuff.
Win or lose, he's out there.
Which I appreciate as a guy who appreciates fashion.
Take some chances.
But he usually gets there about 45 minutes to an hour after the game. I mean, he's also known for his press conferences. You know, the media, of course, is sitting there, particularly the beat writers that have to cover the Panthers. They sit there waiting for him. He's their last interview. They got to get some quotes from him and ask him questions. And sometimes he strolls into those press conferences 45 minutes, an hour after the game.
He's got to get dressed again.
I just can't imagine Bill Belichick dealing with that guy, you know, and that attitude and that he comes with. Now, Jameis Winston's in a rebuild his image mode, right? Go to New Orleans, be a good team player, learn from the quarterback whisperer, Sean Payton, learn from one of the best ever in Drew Brees, and kind of, you know, bide your time, and then who knows what's going to happen with Drew. Maybe he's one and done. Maybe he plays another year. Regardless, Jameis Winston, after a year, if he's the good guy and gets the blessing from Drew and Sean Payton, his career is going to have another big contract.
Yeah.
Okay, we've seen that. With Cam, it's different. He's had a lot of health issues the last couple of years. Things didn't end so well. He wasn't the best teammate in Carolina. So now, he's got to play.
It's a prove-it year.
Or he's just going to be a backup the next couple of years and like RG3, just lucky to get a deal kind of thing.
Yeah, and, you know, I think that going to a program like Bill Belichick could really, you know, make him be completely focused on football. He's going to go into a situation where, you know, Bill gives awards for who can say the least to the media.
Right.
And I think, you know, that could kind of challenge Cam. But, you know, if you're looking at it just from the outsider's perspective, if Cam wants another big contract, he has to earn it this year. And, you know, it's too little too late. I think this is going to be a huge year for Cam as far as where his career goes from here on out.
The interesting thing about this year, you know, with so many storylines with the Patriots dynasty over the last 20 seasons, now you got Tom Brady in Tampa, is who benefits, right?
Yeah.
Can the Patriots be the Patriots without Tom Brady and really without a proven franchise quarterback? This isn't when Peyton Manning left, Andrew Luck stepped in.
Yeah.
This is Tom Brady's gone, and now we got a bunch of guys that we're hoping some, you know, we're hoping Cam's healthy, and we're hoping the young quarterback, you know, we're hoping somebody emerges, but they don't know for sure who their starting quarterback's going to be or their future quarterback.
No, this is going to be a huge year as far as everybody's always worried with Bill Belichick. Is it Bill Belichick or is it Tom Brady? You know, this year is going to be pretty much all on Belichick. You know, he's going in there with a quarterback that's unproven. I mean, Cam Newton's a proven quarterback, but we don't know where he is now as far as his health is in the game and, you know, what he's going to do stylistically to what the Patriots have always done, where the quarterback's in shotgun and, you know, kind of makes all the changes at the line of scrimmage. So I think it's going to be huge just as far as see what Bill does in the situation.
Who do you think at the end of the regular season has a better record or a better, you know, season from a playoff position? Is it the Patriots, who are still – in a division that has the Dolphins, who played better last year than anybody expected, but still not a playoff team yet. The Jets are not a playoff team. The Bills are.
Yeah.
Or Tampa, who surprisingly, I don't know what the line is at the very moment in Vegas, but it was like 8 wins was kind of the over-under for Tampa, which I thought it would be more like 9.5 with Brady. But the point is that, But yet Brady's got to deal with a tougher division. Carolina's improved. People believe in the Saints to win the division. And, of course, Atlanta, it's got a lot of weapons and can be a 9-10 win team possibly. So the Tampa's got a harder road than the Patriots. Maybe better, but maybe the record won't end up that
Bucks
way.
Bucks are at 9.5. New England's at 9.
Okay, so the Bucks are at 9.5 now.
So they're
that's jumped a lot in the
six.
Last couple months. Yeah. So 9.5 for the Bucks and the Patriots are at 9.
9.
So it's pretty even.
It's hard for me to go against Tom Brady, and you know that the weapons he has over there. You got Gronk coming back into it, who I think, you know, Gronk probably needed a year off as much as anybody, the way he was banged up. But then you also have, I think, O.J. Howard's still there. He's a good tight end.
Really good tight end.
You got Evans is a big wide receiver. They got the other one, Godwin,
2,000
a good
yard
one.
Receivers.
I think he's got way more talent. This will be the most talent that's been around Tom Brady, I think, in any other team he's ever had.
Yeah, since he had Randy Moss with the Patriots.
Yeah, so I think –
But you're not getting the Tom Brady of 10 years ago either.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, who could throw it 60 yards to Randy Moss. I don't know if he can do that now.
But he's got he's got wide receivers. He's got tight ends. He's got running backs. I think that there's more around him, and then I just know the way that Tom Brady works. Like right now, he's getting in the little tiffs with Tampa and the mayor, and they're still working out on state land and yeah, I just think, you know, everything you've seen from Tom Brady and his work ethic, and now you're going to give him this many weapons, I think that he's got a better shot.
I think there's no doubt that Tom Brady is going to get a lot of juice with his new home, with his new team. He's going to get a lot of energy, which, you know, I think initially that carries you, right? I mean, and let's face it, he's going to have an easy offseason because his offseason is just whatever he wants to put into it. Not that it's easy, but he's working out, he's throwing, but it's – there's not a lot of organized anything other than Zoom calls and some workouts and some receivers you can meet in somebody's backyard and run routes with. You know what I mean? So it's going to be a different offseason, probably a shortened, probably less practices, less contact, all that sort of thing. Not that quarterbacks have contact, but you know what I mean? It's just going to be a less strenuous offseason. I do think that, man, last year I got all excited and I bought into the Cleveland Browns.
Yeah.
You know, they were on the cover of Sports Illustrated. They had all the weapons. We all thought, okay, this is it. And then that was the biggest letdown we've had in a while. I don't want to be overreactionary because offseason pickups, because that Tampa's defense is still a struggle. But I just can't count against Tom Brady getting 10, 11 wins in Tampa. I do think they're going to somehow figure out a way to get 10 or 11 wins, regardless of what New Orleans does.
He's never not won 10 games, you know?
You got to think of his mindset. Deal. He knows he has 2 or 3 years left. And, like, so this offseason when everybody's probably, you know, waiting, seeing what's happening, he's still getting all the guys together that's still practicing because he knows that he has
one or two, three
at the most. You know, Bill Belichick's probably sitting back saying, okay, we're rebuilding completely. You know, new quarterback. We had a quarterback for 17, 18 years. I think that the urgency for Tom Brady is probably more there than necessarily the Patriots.
I think a lot of teams are going to try to take advantage of Tom Brady not being in New England, and this is their get-back season. Yeah. You know what I mean?
You've
been wearing us out for 10, 20 years. We're going to get our pound of flesh
trying to leave town. But as soon as Tom Brady leaves, and then the Jets like, well, Jamal Adams wants to leave too. Like, the Jets have no hope.
By the way, speaking of the Patriots, Robert Kraft's going to be $1.1 million in the red. Remember, it's been so long. We've had Corona and a lot of other things that have been happening. But going back to last season, the Patriots got in trouble because they had a film crew that was on the sidelines of a future game. It was a documentary crew, had no attachment to the team. It was, you know, everybody's got a million crews that are doing social media packages, TV shows, you name it. And, well, anyway, based on their history and their trouble with the league in the past and Spygate and everything, NFL came down with a hammer the other day. They're fining the Patriots $1.1 million, probably more than everybody on that film crew makes in 2 years, right? $1.1 million and taking away, a third-round draft pick in 2021.
They got busted stealing signals again.
That is.
Everybody does it, but I'm trying to go back. The story was so long ago. I forgot like the name of that. It was like Kraft Media or something. Was there?
One this past year when they got they were on the sidelines. Everybody steals signals, right?
Yeah, everybody does.
I mean, everybody does it in pro baseball. I'm not saying they do it that the Astros did where they bang a trash can and have buzzers or any of that. Yeah. But I'm saying everybody's always trying to figure out the signals.
Oh, yeah, no, there's no doubt. I mean,
NFL has been that way as well.
If you got to get Flynn to tell the story about how he knew all of the defensive signals for Detroit when we were playing there. And so he would always stand next to the coach where Aaron was looking at Matt the whole time. He would get the defensive signals, and he would signal to him. So Aaron always knew. It was like 2 or 3 years of this. Matt knew it down packed, and all of a sudden he makes a call, and it's wrong. And the coach on the other side staring at Matt is like, I got you. I knew you knew my signals. So he got
burned.
But
it took six games or whatever for it to catch up. Wow. I remember a time LSU baseball. I mean, baseball signal stealing's been going on forever, and there's nothing wrong with it. You just can't use
part of the game.
It's just part of the game, but you just can't use technology. Yeah. You know, you can't have a camera in the LSU baseball dugout looking over into Mississippi State's dugout to try to figure out signal. But if you want to watch them give the signals, and if you think you've got to decipher it and you can relay it to the hitter or whatever base runner, then that's all legal to do, and it happens every day, all day. A guy who was great at it was Rick Jones at Tulane. They used to practice it. They would steal signs from second base all the time. They were some of the best sign stealers I'd ever seen in college baseball. I mean, they literally worked on it in practice and were excellent at it. But one time, and Skip didn't like to do it. He always felt like, you know, we got to do that. You know, we were always usually better anyway. Yeah. We didn't have to. But a couple times we did. And one time we were playing Northwestern State in Natchitoches. And
who you're going to steal signals from?
Well, but hang on. Here's the story.
Pick on the little guy.
Jim Wells was the coach, and Jim Wells had been an assistant at LSU in the late 80s for a couple of seasons, and then he got the job at Northwestern State, I think 1990, and really turned around that program. Of course, he ended up at Alabama, and that's who, you know, and did great things at Alabama. LSU beat Alabama in the 97 national championship finale. So this was circa 91, 92, something like that. Jim's over there, and he's building that program, and Skip really didn't change his signs. We had two different sets, but he pretty much went with set one unless something weird was going on. And so Jim knew all of Skip's signs. So as he's calling the pitches, he's standing on top step of Northwestern State's dugout at Alec Box Stadium, and he's relaying. They're relaying them to the hitters, and they jump out on us, and it's, you know, they're up 4 or 5 runs, maybe halfway through the game, and we know what's going on. And coach at first is kind of blowing it off, but then by about the sixth inning, he's getting pissed.
Yeah.
Coach Bertman's getting pissed because, and he stands up on the top of the dugout and he goes, "Hey Jim, what is this one?" And he like gives a signal, yells at him, "What's this one?" You know, so coach is still staying with the macho. We're not going to steal their signs, and we're losing. And finally, like some of the players, myself and a couple other guys, we're sitting there and we're trying to figure out their signals. And finally, we go to him and go, "Coach, we got their signals. Just let us know if you want to use them." He's like, "No, we're not gonna do that. We're good." Another inning goes by. We're still losing. "All right, give them to me. Here we go." He calls up the team. "All right, here we go." This, when you hear Ronnie, you know, it's fastball. Rantz, it's curve. You know, first
you
name, last name,
number,
one of these
it's
deals,
the
right?
If you hear your name, it's
sure
a fastball.
Enough, coach, we come back. Boom, 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 boom. Home run, double. Boom, boom, boom. Come back, win the game. Afterwards, our bullpen catcher, who is a guy named Tim Bauer, Buzzy Bauer, he was from Barb High School in Lake Charles. And he was the one who really cracked the code.
Yeah.
And Skip goes, "Ooh, want to give a game ball to the buzzard. Great job, Bauer, on getting the signals there. You know, we had to get those guys. Couldn't let them win."
So it wasn't that you wanted to go after Northwestern. It was, okay, they've done it long enough.
Yeah.
It's time to go.
It became, like, necessary, right?
That's awesome.
He's Richard Dick Dickson. I'm Ronnie Rantz filling in for Jacob Hester. This is Hanging with Hester, presented by Richard Honda. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll talk a little LSU football, some fallout, and a little rumor mill about Marcel Brooks, of course, still in the transfer portal, which kind of took us by surprise last week. Also, Johnny Manziel kind of said some things that were in the news. We'll talk about all that and more. Don't go anywhere. Hanging with Hester will return right after this.
Hanging with Hester with Jacob Hester. We opened up the playbook and expanded our coverage. Listen daily in high definition on 98.1 HD2. We are 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
I'm Jay Ducote. I grew up learning how to cook at LSU tailgate parties and right in my own backyard. And I created JD's Louisiana products to bring that Louisiana flavor to you at home for your backyard cookout. JD's Louisiana barbecue sauce, Louisiana molasses mustard, spicy and sweet barbecue rub, and more are available at your local supermarkets or by logging on to jdakoti.com/shop. Put in promo code CST for 25% off at checkout.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
If I built a van, it would do more than haul.
It would carry my entire business. I'd make it available in dozens. Make that thousands of configurations.
It would keep an eye on my fleet.
And an eye out for danger.
If I built a van, I'd make it available in diesel and gas. And I'd build it right here in South Carolina.
Introducing the all-new Sprinter, starting at $33,790. Built in the USA.
Bring individual attention in a modern banking atmosphere with a trusted local company. Gulf Coast Bank, invested in technology with a local touch, giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime.
We're building relationships through personal service as a bank that cares about you.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge, no matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111, your law firm for a lifetime.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
How many tables will Ronnie sell this hour? Hangin' with Hester. With Jacob Hester, Ronnie Rantz, and Richard Dickson. 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge. 1130 The Tiger.
Ah, Lloyd, I long for that bumper. You know, the days of selling tables on the cell phone for the Louisiana Sports Hall of Fame.
Hey, if anybody knows, it's me.
We're in, yeah, we're you interned / worked for us for a couple years. You know, we, like everybody with the COVID, with that suffering through the Chinese virus, we're in a little bit of a slow phase. But with Louisiana Sports Hall of Fame right now, which weirdly this past weekend was supposed to be the Hall of Fame induction weekend, because the last weekend in June is always the Hall of Fame induction weekend. So you know, we should have had Nick Saban given his acceptance speech and Phil Robertson.
Perfect year for it too. Have to come back to Louisiana after taking an L in Alabama.
Yeah. So I mean, you know, he would have been humble pie. People would have been backslapping him. You know, coach, you know, I've had some great years. I mean, we got you this year, but you know, hey, and a good luck.
Perfect time.
It would have been perfect. But everything's been postponed at the Louisiana Sports Hall of Fame till the fall. Our golf tournament, which was originally scheduled in April, got pushed back to May. Is now going to be October 4th and 5th. At the Golden Nugget in Lake Charles. We got to get you over there for that one.
I got a tee time for that one, huh? Yeah. I'm in.
You can caddy. We'd love for you to help caddy
that
event.
Before, too.
You
know, like,
but no, Richard can play. You know, well, I mean, he's a celebrity. Got to play in the NFL, coach. Well, what are your accolades? Menard High Beta Club?
Personality, radio personality, right. Intern.
Best mustache.
But yeah, for sure. Yeah. But anyway, that'll be October 4th and 5th at the Golden Nugget. They do a fantastic job over there. And we did it last year, and it was a big time hit. 2-day event. We'll have plenty of info on lasportshall.com. You can buy teams, tickets, individual players. You can put in a foursome. We have the party the night before with $25,000 putting contest. A lot of good stuff. And then our Hall of Fame induction, our 3-day event where we have like 7 or 8 events over 3 days, that got postponed, which was supposed to be this past weekend. It'll now be in the middle of December during the Natchitoches Christmas lights. And I don't know if you've ever been to Natchitoches during the Christmas lights, but it's fantastic. Mm-hmm. And it'll be the first time the Hall of Fame, Louisiana Sports Hall of Fame inductions have taken place during the Christmas festival. So that's just a little backdrop that'll make it interesting and a lot of fun. And, you know, we'll have a bunch of great concerts and
do you think,
celebrity bowling
events.
Is
that going to affect any attendance?
I think it might affect, like, some of the public events, you know, the outdoor Rockin' River Fest on the river and, you know, some of those events a little bit. But I mean, we've got a celebrity kids clinic that we do for the kids of the Natchitoches area and that parish. I mean, folks from all over the state are welcome to come. But like, we've already talked to the school board because school's going to be going on during that time, and they're bussing in kids. They're excited. They're going to send, like, you know, their honor roll students and things like that, because we only have like 400 spots we can do. Yeah. But the point is that I think most people are going to be juiced and excited by the time we get to December. People are going to be looking for some normalcy, something fun and different. And, you know, and I think there will be a segment of the population that will probably always be a little bit timid and a little bit scared. People that are in the super high risk categories, understandably, may be a little bit more timid to be around masses, groups of people. And that's not going to change anytime soon. That'll probably be that way for a year or two until we get our hands on this pandemic. But I think there's another segment of the population, a large segment of the population, that's like, man, look,
I'm ready to go now.
I'm ready to go do some things and have some fun and you know, social distance to a certain degree. But that'll all be going on. You can go to lasportshall.com to get more info. LSU football last week, I know it caught me a surprise. I want to get your reaction. Marcel Brooks, he played 11 games, the freshman linebacker, got a big sack against Florida, showed some things. They had him in some packages rushing the quarterback. So obviously they thought a lot about this Fort Worth, Texas native coming to LSU, thinking he's going to be one of the future better linebackers, especially rushing the quarterback. And he announced that he went into the transfer portal, no real explanation. Yeah. Other than, you know, there was a tweet he put out or whatever that says he wants to, you know, get closer to home. Well, my sister lives in Dallas. You've got family over that way. I mean, it's just not that far.
No, so 6.5 hours.
I mean,
to me, you know, that's typically what you hear from kids is they want to get closer to home. And, you know, we were talking during the break that, you know, since this quarantine or since they were sent home, he's been back in his home life for three and a half, 4 months. And it could be the point where he's just like, man, I like being at home. You know, I don't want to go back to Baton Rouge because he's a guy that we expect a lot of. People have been talking about him being a starter coming up this year. What he did as far as being able to come off the edge, he was kind of a tweener guy that, you know, a little bit smaller to get in the linebacker role, but he was a guy that really played well off the edge and had a lot of special things. There was things that, you know, Bo Pelini was ready to put in place for him. It was definitely a shocker to me because he's a guy that we've been talking a lot about LSU's defense for 4 or 5 months now, and his name is always one of the topics we talk about and what they're going to do with him. So it's something that we're all kind of confused by. You know, if it puts him in a better situation for his at-home life, then good for him. But I'm sure that it's something that, you know, Orgeron's talking to him, the guys are talking to him, and I'm really trying to figure out where his headspace is.
We don't know because when you were in college, when I was in college, they didn't have transfer portals. No. So we don't know what that means, what that's like. There has been more and more examples, though, in all sports where players put themselves in the portal and then take themselves out of the portal.
Yeah.
You know, I would love to see the transfer portal be designated to certain times of the year. You know, these 2 weeks in this month or that month or at the end of each semester or what. But just to have the transfer portal available to you at all time, to where coach gets on your butt at a practice on a Thursday, you get mad, you go home, you pout, and you put your name in the portal at 8 o'clock at night. I mean, that's ridiculous. There should be a procedure in place. There should be a cooling off period. There should be a time where, okay, you can June and January or whatever it is. It just to have it any time year round to me is just kind of sloppy. It leads itself to a lot of, I think, off the cuff decisions by players.
Yeah, there's no question. You know, I had a big problem with it at first because you saw a lot of younger kids doing it, and it's like, well, they get mad or they get getting on to, and it's like, well, they want to be re-recruited. If I put my name in that portal, they got to be nice to me because they want me to stay. And that's what I thought a lot of kids were doing. It, you know, you get in trouble, you have to work your butt up to get, you know, get back in good graces. Well, now it's like, if you're a good football player and you get in trouble, you're like, well, I'm just going to put my name in the portal, and then they're going to have to be nice to me. They're going to want to re-recruit me. I hope that's not the case. I don't think it is in this particular instance, but I'm the same way. I wish that there's a time frame you can be in the portal, and you know, you knew that you have 2 months to think about it, and if you really want to go in the portal, then, you know, in my opinion as a coach, once you go in there, we don't want you back. That's how I would feel. But with this how it's working right now, where you can go in and out whenever you want, you don't really have that much. I guess you're not in that much control.
All right, so
of
you're of the old school belief that if you're a coach and a player says, I'm going to the portal, then it's like, fine. If you don't want to be here, then leave. Like, well, that's your opinion. As opposed to, see, I think back, it's like a relationship, right? You're dating your girlfriend, you're seeing somebody, and they're like, well, I don't think this is working out for him, I'm going to leave. And then, I'm like, oh, wait a minute. Wait, I don't think I want you to leave. And then so you're nice and you, hey, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, did I say something? You know, you kiss their butt a little bit. You take them to the nice meal. You get them some things. You know, I'm so sorry. I don't want you to leave. Like, and there's some girls, right, that will play that. Yeah. Well, I'm going to leave if you don't do X, Y, Z. Or you can be the guy like Richard who says, you know what, if you don't want to be here, fine. Don't let
Kick
the door rocks. Hit you in the,
yeah,
you know
step
what.
On.
Right?
Yeah, I mean, I just think that if you, like you're saying, you want it to be a certain months of the year that you can be in the portal, well, then you know why you're going there. The coaches have an idea that, look, it's not working out. he's probably going to go into the portal, and they're ready to move on at this point. Right now, he could have gotten yelled at 9 a.m., goes home for lunch. Nobody thought it was a big deal, and he's all pissed off and says, okay, well, I'm going in the portal.
Right.
And everybody's like, what? Where'd that come from? I just don't think, like you said, right now it's too easy to go in and out of the portal. I think there's got to be some, you know, rules and regulations put around it.
Was there ever a time when you were at LSU, and usually for a player, it's early on in his career. It's that first year, because the first year traditionally is the hardest, and most of the time, especially in football back in the day, it was a redshirt year, or even if it wasn't a redshirt year, you're not playing much. And so that first year is difficult, right? It's you're away from home. You know, you're getting hazed by your teammates. It's difficult. The dorm's hot. Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of things you got. You know, you got the schedule that you got to get used to with school and study hall, and it's just a lot. Some kids can handle it, some can't, or it takes them a couple years to be able to handle it. Was there ever a time in your darkest hours at LSU early on where you were like, man, I don't know if I want to be here?
Well, there's no question. My freshman year, and I started as a true freshman, played in all 12 and 2, 14 games. It was just the wear and tear. You've been there and you busted your butts. I got there June, had our condition test 2 days later, and then I'm thrown into this role where I'm starting and playing a lot, and you know, you start to get burned out toward the end of the year. It's a long season. You know, I've never been cussed out this much in my life. You know, you know, in high school you didn't get yelled at that much. You're the best player on the team. You know, they're riding my butt every single day, every practice, every afternoon. And there was a point, you know, right in between maybe before we played Notre Dame in the Sugar Bowl, I was like, man, I kind of wouldn't mind going back closer to home. I didn't have any of my buddies I grew up with. They all went to Southern Miss, or they went to Mississippi State, or Ole Miss. I was with a whole new group of people, and I used to joke all the time that Louisiana guys are a whole different breed. When I came over here, I'd never seen so many grown men with shaved arms and shaved legs. I'm like, these guys are freaking weird. I'm about ready to go home. But, you know, I calmed down. I went home.
Were Hester and Flynn, were they shaved legs, shaved arm guys?
No, Flynn wasn't. I had Cotrera, Court, Ace, I mean, all these
workout warriors.
They were shaving. The first time
oil.
I found out what Nair was, they were all coming home and putting Nair on their arms and their legs. And I'm like, you guys are just, y'all are weird, man. This is a whole different breed of person I'm hanging around.
They blame it on the tape. Like, oh, it's because I get my wrist tape. I don't want to have
and you
hair.
Talk to every single one of them, because when the sweat gets on their arms, he goes, you can see all my definition sort
of
a little bit.
Speaking
better.
Of Nair, don't let me forget, Lloyd. Jacob owes me.
Oh, a back rub.
Yeah, well, no, not a back rub. A back waxing. Right? And not by him. I won a bet a few months ago on this show. It was pre-COVID. Okay, won a bet
years ago.
We were trying to get 1,000 YouTube subscribers on the Hangin' with Hester YouTube channel, and we were like at 900 before the show. And you know, hey, if we get 1,000 by the end of the show, you know, I'm gonna get Rantz. That's what he said. I'm gonna get Rantz a back waxing. I'm gonna pay for it someplace. And we did. We got the 1,000 by the end of the day or whatever it was, and I still haven't gotten the back waxing. And 4th of July is coming up. I could use it by this week.
I think you might get more viewers if you make Hester apply the Nair on your back.
No. I don't want that. I want to go to a place. But so anyway, remind me, Lloyd. I gotta get that schedule.
Yeah,
I'm just gonna do it and bring him the receipt.
Yeah, if he doesn't do it, then I'm gonna have to do it. I said I'd do it for $50, and Ronnie's eyes lit up.
Yeah, he said he'd only do it for 50. If we could charge him $100, give you $50, and make $100. There you go. Make $50. There you go. For me, I never had that moment.
Yeah.
I didn't have that moment. Where I thought about leaving once I got to LSU. But a lot of guys did. And I mean, there were a number of guys, there were some guys, and you got to think back. There was he pitched in the big leagues, left-handed pitcher from California. Matter of fact, might've pitched in the big leagues even last year, Vargas.
Yeah. I know.
Remember Vargas, I forget his first name, it was Lefty. He came, in the Smoke Laval era, early on in the Smoke days, ended up transferring, going back, went to Long Beach State, pitched over there with Weaver, you know, pitched in the big leagues with the Angels and stuff. And the guy pitched forever in the major leagues. He was an LSU guy, left, came back, like left in the fall, came back, joined the team, pitched his freshman year, and then left.
Yeah.
And then, you know, of course, went on to be a great pitcher in college at Long Beach State and then pitched in the big leagues. But there were other guys, you know, back then, especially baseball in the olden days, and you could transfer and be eligible right away.
Yeah.
So you could play for LSU in the fall, transfer to, say, Tulane, and if LSU gave you a waiver, you could play for them in the spring. That's how it was prior to 2009. And that's why Tulane was so good, went to the College World Series a couple of times. They always had transfers from Miami, Georgia Tech, things like that. But a lot of guys would do that back then. Not as much anymore, although the portal has kind of It's a wild, wild west. There were over 800 players in baseball in the portal, or 1,000 players in baseball or something in the portal during the COVID. And, of course, they don't have 1,000 spots for them to go to. So a lot of players threw their names in the portal. Drew Bianco being one of them, Mike Bianco's son. And of course, Mike, the head coach at Ole Miss, his son Drew, after 2 years at LSU, or actually a year because he's going to get the sophomore year back, he'll be a sophomore again. But he put his name in the portal for a few weeks, took his name out of the portal. He's still a Tiger. So it's a totally different deal. Speaking of players in the portal, Eric Monroe, who's a safety for the Tigers, graduated from LSU. Coach O said nothing but good things about him last week. He's now landed at Texas Tech. So
it's a great tool for guys like that, in my opinion. You know, that you've been here, you're able to graduate, and you maybe never got the playing time you thought you were going to get. And you move on to a situation where you think that you want to spend your last eligible year playing as much as possible. And I like it for guys like Monroe. It's just something, like you said, I think there still needs to be some tooling around it of when and how many times you can put your name in the portal.
Marcel Brooks from Fort Worth, Texas. He's a big-time athlete, you know, played 11 games for LSU last year, wants to be closer to home. Okay, well, TCU is right there in Fort Worth. We also know a guy by the name of Dave Aranda is in Waco, not that far away from Fort Worth, and he played, you know, Dave Aranda recruited him. He played for him. I would be shocked if it wasn't one of those two landing spots.
No, I definitely think that the spot would be Baylor, just because of he's familiar with Dave Aranda. He can not only go back closer to home, but he's with a defense where he knows how this guy wants to use him. Right now you're looking at a 4-3, and they're trying to figure out, well, do I put weight on him? Do we take weight? Is he going to be more of a safety, or is he going to be a guy coming off the edge? I think that he's probably more comfortable in a Dave Aranda-style defense, and it makes more sense.
It's very similar to what happened to Jacoby Stevens early on, where it's like we put him at wide receiver, running back, safety, linebacker. It's like if you stick around, you'll find a fit. But sometimes it takes a while to figure out if you're going to put weight on or not.
Yeah. So Marcel Brooks, most people, the smart money has him on Baylor. I was talking to Jamie Howard, former LSU quarterback whose son is going to be a junior next year at St. Thomas More, already committed to LSU to play quarterback in a few years. And he said that he was surprised at TCU's facilities. They did a great job recruiting his son, and that their campus and their football facilities, and it's a more big time operation and a more big time feel than I think we know about. Yeah. Right. And of course, Fort Worth's a big time city.
Private school that, they don't have to announce how much money the coaches are making. They keep a lot more things under wrap that where, guys like me and you don't really know what's going on over at TCU.
But they said he said that his son enjoyed the TCU and the experience, and they recruited him hard, and it was super, super impressive. So that's right there in Marcel Brooks' backyard. So obviously that's another option, and would put him in another league. All right, we'll take a break. Richard Dick Dickson, former LSU tight end, NFL tight end as well. We'll be back. I'm Ronnie Rantz. We're filling in for Jacob Hester, who's out today. This is Hanging with Hester, presented by Richard's Honda.
Hanging with Hester with Jacob Hester.
Dear Sports is our love letter to sports. Share your Dear Sports letter with us. Call 860-506-6161 and read it to us. Or share a video or text using the hashtag Dear Sports on Twitter or Instagram.
104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Divorce is hard. Divorce is messy. Divorce is exhausting. The law offices of O.C. Brown walk me through my divorce and help me find the right solution for me, my kids, my finances, and my property.
Call the law offices of O.C. Brown, your law firm for a lifetime.
If I built a van, it would do more than haul.
It would carry my entire business. I'd make it available in dozens. Make that thousands of configurations.
It would keep an eye on my fleet.
In and eye out for danger.
If I built a van, I'd make it available in diesel and gas. And I'd build it right here in South Carolina.
Introducing the all-new Sprinter, starting at $33,790. Built in the USA. Mercedes-Benz. Vans. Born to run.
Hey, T-Bob. Sports wouldn't be the same without the die-hard fans, so we're highlighting the fans that do it the most.
Every week, 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge brings you the Citizens Bank Fan of the Week. Check it out, 104.5ESPN.com.
It's the Citizens Bank Fan of the Week.
To all of our heroes working on the front lines of this COVID-19 pandemic, your bravery and selflessness represent the very best of us, and we want to say thank you. I'm asking everyone around the state to join me in celebrating the heroism of our healthcare professionals on the 19th of every month at 1900 hours, that's 7 p.m. Write a note of appreciation, make plans to donate to charitable organizations, or say a prayer. To learn more, visit 19thanks.org. Thank you, and God bless.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
This isn't just another day, it's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
ServiceMaster Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact ServiceMaster Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. ServiceMaster Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
Means 3-1 great. Hangin with Hester with Jacob Hester. 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge. 1130 The Tiger.
Welcome back to Hangin with Hester. Ronnie Rantz here with you with the Louisiana Sports Hall of Fame. And we've got Richard Dick Dickson, former LSU tight end, here in studio. We're filling in for Jacob Hester, who's on vacation. We'll be back tomorrow. Happy 4th of July week that's coming up. I know a lot of folks are going to be at the beach, going to be with their family.
Are we doing sports shorts Saturday?
Of course.
We don't have to. I mean,
no, we're, of course we are. Sports shorts Saturday morning
from 10 to noon right here on ESPN Radio. Nobody has to show up
Saturday. We'll be celebrating Independence Day on a remote near you.
Do it from the beach. Take them.
Well, I have to be in studio is the thing.
Lloyd has to be in studio. He doesn't care where we do the show at. He's got to be here pressing all the buttons. But how about the Sahara Mist, Desert Storm, Wind, Cloud, whatever the...
Just put it on 2020's docket, dude. Yeah.
The Sahara smoke
that
we've been getting. I mean, that's amazing that you can have dirt from Africa make its way and it affects the haze over here.
So have you really noticed it? I just took it for like it's been raining every day.
Thought it was like L.A.?
Yeah, it just seems like every day for the past week it was storming or cloudy.
This was funny. Kevin Wagner, who's over at LSU Athletics forever and ever, and he does all the TV productions for SEC Network and everything. Kevin posted on his Facebook, the same person that's worried about the Sahara winds and the Sahara sand is this guy, and it was a picture of a ceiling fan with just all kind of crud and dust on the blades of a ceiling fan. Have you ever laid in your bed and looked up at the ceiling fan blades when they've stopped and go, man, I need to get the ladder and clean that off a little bit?
That's the one that always makes you feel like really lazy.
A little bad about yourself.
You're sitting there, and it happened to me not too long ago, laid in bed, and usually the fans are always on. It was a little afternoon nap or something, fan wasn't on. I laid in, I was like, and call my wife.
I need to call my wife. No, I'm going to get up and do it.
I got to go back to work.
But I mean, like, that's people, if check out your ceiling fan, turn it off and check it out. It's usually pretty nasty because you don't get up there and clean it very often.
And especially if you're a person who fans run nonstop in your house, so you never even see it.
Right.
And that rare time you actually lay down and look up and it's not on, it'll get you every time.
Right. It's your own in-house Saharan dust that's going on. All around you. Major League Baseball, you and I are Major League Baseball fans. You told me growing up you were a Rangers fan living over in the Dallas area. And they, you know, Major League Baseball's coming. I didn't know that it was going to happen. I mean, a week ago, I probably would have put it at 50-50. I thought the players were really going to dig in. And finally, the owners said, you know what, this is it. Take it or leave it. And they put a 60-game schedule on there. We'll talk more about that in a minute. But I wanted to get your reaction because it had a big visceral reaction by fans of the Texas Rangers last week. And since that was your team, the Rangers are opening up a new stadium. They were supposed to have opened it up for this season. It'll be available whenever they start playing at the end of July. But Globe Life Park, which the first thing that strikes me is that the Rangers have a new stadium because the ballpark at Arlington, which was originally called, opened in April of 1994. That was only 26 years ago.
Yeah,
I mean, most of the time a stadium that's 26 years old, they don't demolish it and build a new one, but they did. And I will say this, it was funny. I took a tour of that stadium in 1995. I was playing minor league ball for the Tyler Wildcatters over in Texas, in the Texas Louisiana League. And we had a day off or something. It was right around 4th of July.
Yeah.
So it was about 25 years ago. And we're doing the tour. It's like the backstage tour where they take you through the locker room and you go here and you go to the suites. Well, one of the things was they brought you on the field and you got to stand behind home plate and all this stuff. And I'm standing behind home plate, and I'm looking out at the mound, and I'm literally directly behind it. I'm like, man, I think the plate's crooked. Like, I think it's just a little. It just doesn't. I think it's just a little off.
They're trying to show it off, and you're criticizing.
And they were on the road. The Rangers were on the road. They weren't at home, but they had the grounds crew guys were out there working, sprinkling, doing all their thing. And this one guy's like, oh, hey, come, you know, the guy's ushering me along. All right, the tour's moving along, you know, And one of the grounds crew guys comes up to me and he says, what are you looking at? And I'm like, dude, call me crazy, but look, stand right here and just look at the rubber. Like, doesn't it just look a little teeny bit off?
Dude, Menard was like that.
And he's like,
Vanellick.
He's like, I don't know, man. He's like, nah, I can't. It can't be. And I was like, oh, yeah, you're right. You're right. So maybe say, all right, see you later. I go on the tour. About 10 minutes later, we're walking through one of the concourses, and I look back at the field, and there's two dudes with a tape measure, and they've got like they're like measuring it, and they got like three guys all kind of looking. And say, I don't know if it was off or not. I don't know if they measured it all, and they came to the conclusion that the guy on the tour was crazy, it was fine, or if they dug that thing up and moved it a little bit. But I'd love to know. But anyway, that was 25 years ago. They've already knocked that thing down. They got a new one. Well, actually, they didn't knock it down, but they got a new one. And the pictures came out, and it was done, and they started putting all the pictures out, and people are losing their mind over this new Globe Life Park and where the Rangers are playing, saying it looks like a Home Depot.
Yeah,
looks like just a big warehouse building. Where's this $2 billion building? It's a retractable roof, which is nice because the other one wasn't. It was so hot. That was the biggest complaint. You wouldn't get the air circulating in there, and it was just so miserable. But this one has a retractable roof, just like Minute Maid in Houston. Your reaction when you saw the pictures were what?
Way too much tin. It just looked like a big tin can. But like you said, you know, it's got a retractable roof. I'm sure it looks great on the inside. But when you're hearing about this $1.2 billion stadium, you're thinking glass. You're thinking, you know, all this architectural work. And from the pictures what we're seeing, it just looks like a huge tin can that can open up.
Yeah, if you go to the 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge huddle or download it on your smartphone, you can look. Lloyd posted a picture from the parking lot. And it's nice. Don't get me wrong. Like, there's nothing wrong with it. But when you look at it, you're just kind of underwhelmed. The thing about the ballpark at Arlington, the old Globe Life Park, was it was really cool, man. When you like they're showing it on they're showing it right there. There's the picture. They're nice, nice job. That's how it works here. It's magic. They're
a
showing
better than sports shorts quality. We
yeah,
got here.
We don't have this button on Saturday morning. So Globe Life Park, it's nice. Don't get me wrong. And when you're in it, I'm sure it's nice. Supposedly they have larger seats. I don't know if that's good for you and I, Richard. Like they've got some seats that are like big boy seats or something. I don't know. I'd pay extra for that.
It's got no ballpark feel.
$1.2 billion, like you said, 25 years later. I just don't see.
I want to be wild.
Yeah,
for my $1.2 billion.
You want Jerry's World.
When you think of like what they did with the Atlanta Falcons, and when they came out, I mean, the architectural design on that was just.
The nest.
Yeah, it was over ridiculous. There, right? When you're hearing $1.2 billion and then you open your mind to see that, it just doesn't look like a new building. It looks like.
An airplane hangar.
It looks like a giant airplane hangar. That's exactly right. The architectural part of the roof is not much. The sides look like a really nice warehouse district.
Looks like Buddy got a little tight, and they're like, well, I'll just throw some tin on there. We'll be calling
it
a day.
Finish it off with tin, not glass.
not glass.
And the thing that people are upset about over in Texas that are Ranger fans is that supposedly, and I don't know if we can find the before and after, but the renderings that they were showing everybody that were like, this is what it's going to look like. And then what it looked like, not quite the same thing.
And I think the big difference was they were using glass in the renderings where it looks all fancy and you know you got the reflection coming out the glass. You can see into the building.
See, look.
And they replaced that.
I'm showing Richard right now. This is the rendering of what it was supposed to look like. Now, and that's glass, right?
Yeah, like not tin.
On the original rendering, the roof was sort of like an aqua-colored glass, and it looked very state-of-the-art.
Looked billionaire.
Instead, they went with some aluminum siding, which has a warranty that's amazing. Yeah. You know, and you just hose it down, and it just comes right off. I mean, you know,
it's going with baseball well. And there's nothing like sleeping under nice rain on a tin roof. They're going to get a nice boring baseball game. The rain comes in, starts hitting the tin roof.
They're going to close the roof, and it's going to be so loud.
Everybody
gets
gets a blanket at their seat. You know, it's going to be the best nap place ever.
Oh my goodness, that is just too funny. All right, we'll take a break. We'll come back. We'll talk a little Major League Baseball. Hey, at least it's happening. 60-game schedule. That's like college schedule.
Yeah.
We'll talk about that with Richard Dick Dickson next. I'm Ronnie Rantz. Hanging with Hester, presented by Richard's Honda.
This is a house call. This is a test result. This is a prescription refill. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare. Start your virtual visit today at Ochsner Health.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
Richard's Honda want to help. If your car needs service, we'll pick it up and drop it off, fixed and sanitized. If you need a new car, use our buy from home option or call us and we'll deliver it right to your door with no payments for 90 days. We are all in this together, and together we'll get through it. For more information, log on to richardshonda.com today.
I'm Jay Ducote. I grew up learning how to cook at LSU tailgate parties and right in my own backyard. And I created JD's Louisiana products to bring that Louisiana flavor to you at home for your backyard cookout. JD's Louisiana barbecue sauce, Louisiana molasses mustard, spicy and sweet barbecue rub, and more are available at your local supermarkets or by logging on to jdakoti.com/shop. Put in promo code CST for 25% off at checkout.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is a local bank with a straightforward philosophy.
It's about doing the right thing for our customers.
Participating in our community with annual local fundraisers. Offering individual attention in a modern banking atmosphere with a trusted local company. Gulf Coast Bank invested in technology with a local touch, giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime.
We're building relationships through personal service as a bank that cares about you.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge, no matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111, your law firm for a lifetime.
Live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge studio, welcome back to Hangin' with Hester with Jacob Hester, 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge, 11:30 The Tiger.
We'll be back hour number two next, Hangin' with Hester.
Hangin' with Hester with Jacob Hester. We at 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge have been wondering who would be tough enough to handle
this
the huddle. Just who was built with...
This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care. It's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
If I built a van, it would do more than haul.
It would carry my entire business.
I'd make it available in dozens. Make that thousands of configurations.
It would keep an eye on my fleet.
And an eye out for danger.
If I built a van, I'd make it available in diesel and gas. And I'd build it right here in South Carolina.
Introducing the all-new Sprinter, starting at $33,790. Built in the USA. Mercedes-Benz. Vans. Born to run.
To all of our heroes working on the front lines of this COVID-19 pandemic, your bravery and selflessness represent the very best of us, and we want to say thank you. I'm asking everyone around the state to join me in celebrating the heroism of our healthcare professionals on the 19th of every month at 1900 hours, that's 7 p.m. Write a note of appreciation, make plans to donate to charitable organizations, or say a prayer. To learn more, visit 19thanks.org. Thank you, and God bless.
When you want the best of Louisiana, you don't go to a superstore. We know what we like, and we like it local. Same goes for banking. As one of Louisiana's largest local banks, we offer homegrown services crafted around you. Gulf Coast Bank, the bank that cares about you.
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Andiamo insieme da me, non c'è.
Call Mr. Electric today for electrical repairs, upgrades, and installations.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
At All Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Visit Bayou.
Live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge studio, welcome back to Hangin' with Hester with Jacob Hester, 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge, 1130 The Tiger.
Hour number two in the house, Ronnie Rantz and Richard Dickson filling in for Jacob Hester. We'll be back here in studio tomorrow enjoying a day off with the fam. And we were talking before hour number one was wrapping up. We were talking a little Major League Baseball and how the folks are losing their mind over the Texas Rangers Stadium. And you told me that one of the best, you know, is everybody spoofing the different, the new Rangers Stadium, saying that it looks ridiculous, looks like a giant warehouse. and it doesn't look anything like the pictures that were shown, the drawings, the renderings that were shown to the fans of what it was going to be.
Yeah.
And then 1.2 billion later, what the result was. And you said, what was the analogy you
used? They said, this is what she looks like on Instagram, and this is what she looks like in real life.
Right. Right, 100%.
It makes sense in this instance.
Yeah, you've been with your wife since college, high school.
Yeah, known each other since college.
Since college, okay. And then Lloyd's been with his girlfriend for like a dozen years.
Somebody's got to pay the bills.
So, you know, I'm the only single guy here in the group, and I will take it to the next step. I got fooled years ago when I did one of these online dating deals. You know, you got Tinder and Bumble and Match.com and Plenty of Fish in the Sea and Farmer's Daughter, whatever it is. I mean, Farmers, what is it? The
Farmers Only?
Farmers Only? Yeah. I don't know, whatever. Like you got that. All these different sites.
I don't
sites
think you would be
things.
On Farmers Only.
I wasn't on, no, I'm not on that. I don't even know how to hold a pitchfork. So anyway,
you get exploited real quick on that.
Well, yeah. I mean, but the point is that I was on I think it was Match. This was years ago.
Ashley
maybe
Madison.
10. No, that's for married people. I was never married. So I was like 10 years ago, and it was before I got texted Texas Rangered is really what happened. It was before I knew that the selfie pic where they hold the camera real up high.
Angles.
Paul,
all
you know
angles.
What I'm talking about. That all the girls do, the bigger girls. You know, they hold the picture, the camera way up high.
Yeah.
Okay. If you get that photo, those photos sent to you where the camera, and they're looking way up, you know what that means. We all know what that photo means. I mean, let's just not kid ourselves. We know. Add a bunch of LBs to the deal, okay? I didn't know this yet. I got Texas Rangered, you know, and the pictures came in, and anyway, we're gonna meet for coffee or something, you know. Actually, we were meeting at this is a great story.
Probably wanted full breakfast.
Why not? Let's go for it. So we were meeting at the walk-ons by LSU. Okay, we were meeting by the walk-ons by LSU. We're gonna meet like on a Sunday at 4 or something. I mean, whatever. I was picking an off hour. Yeah, you know, just trying to let's just get in. You know, who knows? You might be there 30 minutes, you might be there an hour. You don't know. You just want to go for a drink, meet somebody, and it might work out, it might not. So anyway, I show up and they had an LSU baseball rainout the day before. And the time that we agreed to meet is in the middle of a doubleheader, coach. In the middle of a doubleheader. So there's 700 people at walk-ons. Yeah. Okay. And I'm gonna know 350 of them, right? So I pull up. I mean, there's line out the door, and I pull up, and the young lady was waiting at the door, and I realized right then and there I got Texas Ranger. You know, I realized right then and there I'm like, oh man, those pictures are 10 years old. They're probably the mall. The thing in the mall? Glamour shots. Yeah. Remember glamour shots in the mall, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They're glamour shot photos. They're 8 to 10 years old, and they're 20 to 40 pounds, 30, 40 pounds ago. Okay. being a nice guy. Nowadays, I'd have just kept driving it. I sent a text. I got in an accident. Something happened. I don't know. I might not have sent it. I don't know. But
typical
but
reason.
I was a nice guy, and I decided to. I'm not gonna. So this is what I did. I pulled up. I didn't get out of the truck. I rolled down the window like halfway. I don't even know why halfway.
This is your nice guy routine?
I didn't want to pull it down all the way. I pulled it halfway. I stuck my arm down. Hey, and waved her over. Said, hey, it's really packed over here. It's going to take a while to get a table. Like, how about we go on the other side of campus? Because I mean, I think it was like spring break or something. You know, like
we're going to go to Roberto's.
Roberto's.
I know to be people
The only reason there was anybody there was because of this doubleheader. So I knew like, so we literally go to, it was when Serrano's was open back in the day, the Mexican place, which I loved. Let's go over there. So she jumps in the truck with me. Doesn't know me from Adam, by the way. Sketchy, right? That's sketchy, right?
You look like a nice guy.
Jumps in the truck. We go over to the Serrano's on the other side of campus. And there's nobody on the patio. Like, I mean, I'm like, this is perfect. We're going to get a drink. I'm
going to
get in, out. I can get in and out of this. You know, hey, it didn't happen. It didn't work out. I got Texas Rangered by the up, the high camera photo. It's okay. So we're sitting there having a drink. The lady comes over. Y'all like a menu? No. Good. Yeah. Don't want the chips and salsa. Just give me the drink.
Let me guzzle it.
I mean, I got a table in the corner. I think I'm watching hockey. I don't even like hockey. Like, I'm just, So we get the drink. I'm ready to pay the bill. I mean, this is going to be good. I can get in and out of there. And I'm thinking, nobody's going to see me. This is perfect. Right about the time that I'm literally about to settle up, I get a hand on the shoulder, a female voice, Ronnie, hey. And I turn around, and it's Palminari's wife, another assistant coach, David Gruey's wife, the old pitching coach, and Javi Sanchez's wife, Michelle, who I was good friends with, Javi and Michelle. And Michelle knew I was going on a Match.com date, right? Didn't know where I was going. Just by chance ran into her. I spun and jumped up so quickly, swooped them over, put them at a table, never introduced them. I haven't moved that fast since it's like I was like 18-year-old, you know, high school football combine or something.
Tried to break the mile.
I literally scooped them up, sat them down. Hey, how did we do in the first game of the doubleheader? I mean, I'm flipping the script. And we won, we lost, whatever. Oh, it's great, it's great. Michelle, I'm blocking them from this person. And Michelle looks at me and looks up and goes, is that her? Like, you know, like she knew, like, is that her? And I was like, yes. And she just kind of like bites her lip and is like laughing. I'm like, hey, good to see you. I run over. I throw the cash on the table. Let's go. You know, I mean, the bottom line was got to walk-ons, made it to Serrano's, got a drink, back to the car, made up a reason to leave, 38 minutes. Like the whole thing took 38 minutes.
Only saw two people you knew.
Got out of there and was like, okay, hey, you know, I got Texas Rangered by the high camera photos. I'm going to learn my lesson. I'm going to be better in the future. 5 minutes down the road, get a text message. Had a great time. Let's do it again. Can you believe that? Can you believe it?
38 minutes.
38
around,
minutes in and out. Went to two different places.
She loved it.
And had a great time. Let's do it again. Like, what?
This guy wanted to fit me in. He knew it was a busy day.
Like, what? Oh, my goodness.
Did you respond?
No.
Got a new phone, probably.
No, but my point is that I love your analogy. The old Texas Ranger photos, that was Instagram. They Instagrammed the fans a year or two ago, but the actual finale.
Real life
ain't so pretty. It ain't like Instagram. They got bamboozled by the high camera photo. Not about it. All right. I don't even know where we were. Oh, we're talking Major League Baseball. What a transition. We were talking Rangers, but Major League Baseball is happening. They're actually going to start spring training this week.
Yep.
The players are I texted a friend of mine trying to get him on the show just a minute ago, the bench coach for the Kansas City Royals. And they're like coaches and staff and all. They're like in the stadium right now doing stuff. And players will be there in a couple days. They'll be playing in a few weeks. 60-game schedule. This is much like the 56-game schedule that college plays. You throw in, say, four games for the SEC tournament. That's 60 games. So Major League Baseball is going to be playing basically a college schedule, probably with less days off than what you have in college baseball, because you never play, like, say, on a Thursday. You get at least one or two midweek days off. You may not have that with Major League Baseball. You might only have one day off, if that. But are you excited about this condensed, shortened season?
I think it's going to be interesting. I'm not a big regular season baseball guy. I typically start watching around the playoffs. But, you know, we were talking the other day as far as a lot of pitchers sometimes, you know, it takes a while for them to get in their rhythm, or even hitters. You know, you can go through a slump, but, you know, in a 160-game schedule, you usually know how to get yourself right at the right times. Is it going to be a little bit different this year because, you know, guys have been sitting at home the last few months, not sure when they were going to start, what they were going to do, and now it's all of a sudden they got to get jump-started. They get told last week it's going to happen, and you know, you got to be ready to go in 4 weeks.
This changes a lot when it comes to a pitching standpoint, because even though the schedule is like college in the sense the number of games, the way it's going to be spaced out is, we know, is going to be more condensed. In college baseball, guys throw once a week, you know, traditionally. You know, you throw, you go five plus innings, you're not going to throw again until the next week. In Major League Baseball, they pitch every 5 days. That means you throw on Monday, you could be throwing again on Saturday. So I don't know how that's going to play out in this condensed. You're not going to get the ace more as often. But the thing is, what you're going to do is, I think it puts an emphasis on game one. You don't have 162 games to figure it out.
Yeah.
You can't fall behind six games in the standings and think, hey, we'll surge in the second half. 60 games, you fall behind six games, I mean, the season's going to be over with.
Well, and typically there's a pitch count. You got first game of the year, guy's not going out and throwing nine innings, 130-something balls.
Right.
So, you know, how long does it take before you're going to let a guy throw a full game? You know, because right now you're going to throw six innings. I mean, you feel good on your first start. Get the six, seven innings is kind of the goal. How long before guys are going to be able to pitch a full game on this shortened schedule?
I think they're going to take the gloves off right away.
Yeah.
I think because you had a month and plus of spring training, most guys, I mean, these guys are professionals. They've been throwing. They've been doing their bullpens and things like that for the last few months. Plus, we only got you for 60 games. You're going to have spring training for, you know, 3 weeks at least. I think you're going to see them go full bore because we only have 60 games.
Yeah.
You know, let go for it. Now, will there be pitchers, the big money pitchers, that say, hey, if you want me to come back and play, or, you know, is there going to be a negotiation between your franchise player of that you have locked up for 3-4 years? You're not going to want to take a chance and hurt that guy in a 60-game condensed corona season. So there's going to be some give and take, I'm sure. But for the most part, I think you're going to see gloves off because, hey, we don't have time to work these players in. We've only got 60 games.
And that's kind of what I was thinking of as far as a franchise pitcher. You know, your ace on the squad, he doesn't want to change his typical routine for this shortened season. I would think that, you know, he wants to go in and work his typical pitch count, get in and get out, and stay as healthy as possible. And he's more worried about his arm next year than keeping his arm to win games in a shortened season.
The in college baseball, the coaches really control the game. Like when you look over, Paul Maneri like gives the signals. I mean, the hitters, the base runners, they all look into the dugout. He tells them the bunt. He tells them the steal. Alan Dunn tells what pitches are coming.
Yeah.
A lot of times, Alan Dunn's going to tell you when to pick off, pitch out. All of that is being controlled by the coaches. And Major League Baseball, not so much, hardly at all during the season. But if you watch Major League Baseball closely, when they get the postseason, that changes.
Yeah.
You'll see a lot more signals being flashed from the dugout, even down the stretch. I mean, in the big games, you'll see a lot more control by the manager. I'm curious if it's going to change because with a 60-game schedule versus 162, every game matters. I mean, every game's just as big. So I think you're going to see Major League Baseball take on the shape a little bit of college baseball from a control by the manager standpoint, which makes it more fun for the managers, especially the National League managers are more used to it versus the American League managers. Oh, by the way, there's going to be a DH in both leagues this year. They're not letting the pitchers hit, which I like. But I think it's going to change a little bit of how the game's played out.
And do you think that, you know, depending on the interaction with the fans, that when every game counts more, that it could, you know, maybe be something they look at and say, hey, do we really need to play 160 games? I mean, because there's a lot of times, like I talked to you earlier, I knew a lot of guys playing Major League, and like one day did not mean anything to them. Like win, lose, don't really matter, you know. And as a football mindset, you were so aggravated with each loss because everything meant so much. And baseball players are like, we got 155 games left to go.
The reason that they're not going to change is because they want the money.
Yeah.
You know, you play 162 games so you can pay Steve Trout, you know, $40 million.
Yeah.
I mean, Mike Trout. Steve Trout would never get
$40 million.
Steve Trout's
a hell of a deal.
Steve Trout, he never got $40 million in his whole career combined. But, you know, Mike Trout, you can pay him $40 million because you play that many games. So in order to have all those gates and all those suites, and they're not going to change that model. Yeah. But I agree with you. I think 162 games is too much.
Yeah.
I don't think it's necessary. But if you want, it's all about dollars and cents in order to create the revenue and TV dollars and everything. They play those games. So and obviously players don't want to take a pay cut. So it is what it is. You got to do it. But I don't know. I'm excited. I'm excited about they're finally back, even though reluctantly. I'm curious to see does anybody hold out?
Yeah.
Are there any players to say, I'm not going back to play for this what prorated amount?
What was the pitcher, young pitcher down?
I think for the Rays. Florida.
Yeah. He came out and said, my full contract, I'm not playing at all.
Snell.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Has he stuck to that? Too.
I don't know yet. Yeah. We'll find out. I mean, we'll find out
that'll
in a few days
if
he shows up. And believe me, the Rays is one franchise I can't afford to pay him his full deal. I mean, with no fans, I mean, that's at the end of the day, I mean, let's be realistic.
The owners
are
losing money.
We all want to make as much money as we can, but there's no justification for those players to be able to make their full salary. I mean, there just isn't. I mean,
especially with Steve Trout out there.
with no fans in the stands and no suites sold and no sponsorships. I mean, like.
Well, and not only that, you're talking about commercial time, your TV contracts. You're playing less than half the games. I mean, so those TV contracts are probably more of a prorated of what they're going to pay you because they don't get that full schedule.
The other thing, too, is that. You talk about everything relies on television for the most part when it comes to sports. Okay. Just like here at Guarantee Broadcasting, any radio station, any local TV station, everyone is feeling the effects of the corona because businesses have less money.
Yeah.
Most of them are making less money than they did prior to the pandemic, which means they have less money to spend on advertising. Mm-hmm. You've got some businesses that have cut out advertising almost entirely because they're trying to keep all the cash they have on hand to be able to stay afloat. So it's not just that the fans aren't there or that the suites aren't. Even if you were wide open, you would probably be creating less revenue. You'd have less season tickets. You'd have less suites sold. You'd have less TV dollars coming in. So it's a very much a have and a have not world because with the pandemic, more people are watching TV for the most part. You're seeing ratings be up for sports for the most part. So there's a demand for the sports because they have more free time and they're in front of their tubes more, especially with social distancing. But yet you've got less advertising dollars that are out there for your team to go get, your marketing team to go get. So
I've seen a couple different models, which is interesting as far as like creating social distancing. I saw a model for, I think it was New Orleans Saints. They're cutting out like rows 7, 8, 9. You know, and now they're blocking off and they're putting new advertisement there. Mm-hmm. And so they're going to take out rows where people would normally seat and sell more advertising spots for as far as the home games.
Yeah, the New Orleans Saints and all NFL teams this year, I think it's the first 8 rows, I believe, or something like that in the stands. They will not seat anyone there. They're saying that that's for social distancing and to keep the fans, if you will, away from players and staff. You know, at least to have less chance of infecting them from the stands. That
I think it's more about advertising.
I mean, let's face it. When you watch soccer, what do you see?
Yeah, it's
you see
but
green grass and advertising.
Exactly.
That's all you see. You don't know if there's 100,000 people in the stands or if there's 2 people in the stands. You just see advertising and green grass. And I think they're taking that model. And now, when you watch an NFL game, at least for this year, you're just going to see field. Players and advertising.
Yep.
You know, and why not? Hang with Hester, presented by Richard Honda. He's Richard Dick Dickson. I'm Ronnie Rantz. We'll take a break and be back with more. Don't go anywhere.
Hanging with Hester with Jacob Hester.
All right, as you know, Hungry Howie's brings you Hanging with Hester every single weekday. They have got so many different flavors of that flavor crust that we always tell you about over at Hungry Howie's. Not just one option. They have multiple options with butter. They have butter cheese. They've got the ranch. They've got the onion. Cajun, if you want a little spice, sesame, garlic, herb, they've got it all over at Hungry Howie's. And so many different ways to get that flavor crust and all the deals they have at Hungry Howie's to you. You can order it at hungryhowies.com. Of course, you can call them at 761-HOWIE. You can visit them at their Nicholson location. It's open from 10 a.m. until 4 a.m. Also, the Hungry Howie's app is always available to you. I encourage you every single day to go check out hungryhowies.com because we always tell you about the deals they've got going on. The mix and match deal where you can choose any 2 for $5.99 each is one of our favorites, but it's not the only deal. They have multiple deals on the website, top right corner. Go check it out there. It's going to pull up something that you're going to want to order or pick up today. Again, 761-HOWIE and HungryHowies.com.
Our listeners fire off their opinions on the JimsFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the JimsFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Visit Bayou Ford for a new 2020 Ford F-150 for only $30,400 with 0% for 72 months. And all new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. The crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
To all of our heroes working on the front lines of this COVID-19 pandemic, your bravery and selflessness represent the very best of us, and we want to say thank you. I'm asking everyone around the state to join me in celebrating the heroism of our healthcare professionals on the 19th of every month at 1900 hours, that's 7 p.m. Write a note of appreciation, make plans to donate to charitable organizations, or say a prayer. To learn more, visit 19thanks.org. Thank you, and God bless.
For over 50 years, customers have been heading to Happy Town for the Corvell Toyota experience. Get outstanding service with our complimentary loaner program when you buy your next vehicle at Corvell Toyota. So come on down to Happy Town. That's Corvell Toyota in Opelousas, Happy Town, USA.
Richards Honda is constantly looking for smart ways to make things easier for you. So we created our Buy From Home option. It's the easiest, most convenient way to shop for a car, all from the comforts and safety of your own home. Just log on to RichardsHonda.com, click on the Buy From Home button, and with a few simple steps, your new or pre-owned car will be ready for pickup or delivered right to your door. It's fast, easy, and smart. Try it today at RichardsHonda.com.
Do you know the proper way to prevent the spread of COVID-19 in your office? We do. We're Janie King, a leader in the cleaning industry for over 30 years, and we've developed comprehensive programs to address proper cleaning and disinfection. We have experience in applying disinfecting programs in hospitals, office buildings, schools, and other venues. Now we're ready to help and able to assist customers that need disinfecting services.
Janie King, the king of clean.
Here at the Big Squeezy, we continue to serve the Baton Rouge and Southeast Louisiana areas during these troubling times. We are dedicated to providing you healthy food items to help you live your best life. From our cold-pressed juices to our delicious smoothies, let the Big Squeezy keep you going. Stay active, stay happy, and let us help you stay healthy. Visit us at our locations and also inside of Alexander's and Matherne's grocery stores or online at thebigsqueezy.com.
Oh, hey, what's up? It's Big V and Bubba, 100.7 The Tiger Morning Show. We'd love for you to join us every weekday, 4 a.m. till 9 a.m.
Yeah, everything you want in a show, country music. We got laughs. We got celebrity in studio guests. We just need you.
Join us every weekday morning, 4 a.m. to 9 a.m., right where it all started.
That's right. Louisiana's country station, 100.7 The Tiger.
Prompt, professional, reliable. If you're looking for a breath of fresh air with your AC and heating needs, call the professionals at Anison Bitter. Anison Bitter, a Rheem Pro partner, keeping your family comfortable for over 25 years.
Now, more from the 2007 national champion, Hangin' with Hester, with Jacob Hester, 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge, 1130 The Tiger.
Ronnie Rantz and Richard Dickson filling in for Jacob Hester. A couple things. One, we need a drop that says now back to the 91 and 93 national champion, Ronnie
well,
Rantz, as opposed to the
Dickson can hold that 2007.
That's true. You got the banner. You got the belt and the ring to prove it. It's just so hard to get Prince or Hall & Oates played on this show, isn't it? I just don't understand why. I mean, I requested from Lloyd, Super Lloyd, the intern on the Wheels of Steel an hour ago, hey, let's listen to Hall & Oates and Prince the rest of the show. Those are my two of my favorite bands of all. Not one song the entire show.
Yeah, I think he's just testing you.
Yeah, I was going to do it, but then I see the suggestions that come up, and they're all just bangers, so I'm playing the ones that I'm playing the hits, baby.
She's a Rich Girl. Kiss on My Lips. Sarah Smiles. I mean, you know, and then you go on the Prince side, Little Red Corvette,
Little Red
Purple
Corvette,
Rain,
your favorite
1999.
Song.
I mean, on and on and on.
Not
Nikki,
a great
we
argument.
Can play Nikki, but I mean, like, yeah. So,
or you could have Eddie Grant, Electric Avenue, and just have a time and a half.
Yeah, there it is. That's not Prince. That's not Hall and Oates.
I'd love to see if they did a cover.
It is a good song, though. And you don't know what it's about, do you?
No.
I mean, it's way before your time.
Well, when I think of this, I just think of the PFT on Barstool.
It's about cocaine and back in the early 80s.
Wouldn't know anything about that.
Just
Ron,
about all those bands show. Were about yeah. cocaine in the 80s.
Yeah, exactly. It really were.
I wonder what Hall and Oates was up to.
So, Daryl Hall's fantastic. By the way, Daryl Hall and John Oates, they were in Baton Rouge years ago. They played a St. Jude. This is like maybe 20 years ago. They played a St. Jude concert at the PMAC. It was back when they used to do this fundraiser concert, and it'd be like five different bands, and it had a bunch of country acts.
Yeah.
And then like Hall & Oates came on last, and I could care less about all the country acts. I was just waiting for Hall & Oates. And unfortunately, like they didn't come on to like, I mean, almost midnight. I mean, by the time, because all the other bands were going long. And so, I mean, I hung in there. People were leaving because it was like a Wednesday night.
Their fans
know?
Had the medicine to make them wait until the late
right,
show.
Right. So I'm hanging in there, right? I mean, I'm here. I forget Trisha Yearwood. I want Hall & Oates, right? So I'm sitting there and I make my way. I mean, I start off, it was tables on the floor and then general admission in the stands. And I was at one of the back tables, but I end up at the front. I crash the Mokla beverage table. Patrick and Tim Mokla were up there. And I get up there in the front row and I'm so excited. You know, here's Hall & Oates. I've hung in there. It's midnight on a Wednesday. They take the stage and Daryl Hall comes out and he's got shades on, like dark sunglasses. And everybody all night long, whenever they took the stage, would be like, man, we're so great, glad to be here in Baton Rouge. What a great cause. Yeah. We're raising money for St. Jude's Hospital and blah, 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 right? So a couple songs in, it's time for Daryl Hall to do the same thing, you know? One problem, he's so trashed. He doesn't know what city he's in or the cause, right?
I've been to a concert
like
that.
You know, and so he's like, hey, it's great to be here tonight.
What a crowd.
And you could tell he's trying to remember, where am I?
What's going on?
And he's just like, hey, man, so great to be here and such good cause that we're here for. And right about that time, Oates, John Oates, the little guy, guy with the jerry curl that stands next to Hall & Oates with the perm, he chimes in on the mic like, hey, it's great to be here in Baton Rouge for the St. Jude's Classic. Here's a great hit from back in the early 80s, you know, Rich Girl,
Kiss
you know,
my
whatever.
List.
Like,
yeah.
Yeah, and like they get right into the song. And Daryl Hall sounded great. He was fantastic. He just had sunglasses on. He was high as a kite.
Yeah.
No clue where he was, what the cause was. I was so happy, though, nonetheless.
That happened to me at a Dave Matthews concert one time.
Oh, Dave will do that real quick.
He got up there and he said, he's like, we're just going to jam for a little bit. He was so drunk he couldn't get his own words out. So they just went to like a jam band session for about an hour.
And that's exactly why I don't like Dave Matthews.
I
love his old CDs from the 90s. But then at some point around 2000, he just started getting weird. And every song's a jam session song. Like every song's 15 minutes,
it's
no words.
It's different at every concert.
Yeah, it sounds different. You're like, oh, wait a minute. Is that ants marching? I can't tell. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like
he dabbles in the psychedelics.
Yeah. It's just, give me a couple of his old CDs from the back in the day. It's a little NFL news, kind of the TMZ version of the show. Johnny Manziel did an interview and came out and said that his football days are in the rearview mirror.
Oh, shocker.
Did he need to announce that?
I mean,
I don't think he needed to announce that. I think we knew, right?
I thought that was kind of the case the last 3 or 4 years. I know he went and tried to play in the Canadian League, but once you get kicked out of the Canadian League.
He did the AF.
He did the CFL.
Got banned in the CFL.
When you get banned from the CFL.
Said they didn't want him, yeah.
I mean, your hopes of getting back to the NFL are done.
I mean, there's prisoners that have played in the CFL. And Johnny Manziel. I mean, biggest busts for Heisman Trophy winners.
He's
got to be on that list, right?
Oh, there's no doubt. I mean, he's a guy.
Although, is Johnny Manziel a bigger bust or Tim Tebow?
No, Tim Tebow at least won a playoff game.
Yeah, true.
He battled it out. He never – you're not going to say, you know, as far as a bust, Johnny Manziel was a first-round draft pick that was kicked out in year two. I mean, that's pretty hard to do. I mean, you pick out a guy with a lot of guaranteed money – Tim Tebow stuck around. He won a playoff game. you can't call him the bust that Johnny Manziel
was. But you knew what you were getting with Tim Tebow. Like, you saw his skill set, yeah. And it was very obvious you're going to get Tim Tebow. The potential with Manziel is what, you know, kind of fascinated
when you had
everybody.
A kid that was suspended and wearing a fake mustache and a wig to go out in Las Vegas the night before, you know, and fly back on an off week for a game. I mean, his mindset was just terrible day one. I think he's a guy that you saw what he could do in college and, you know, was so miraculous.
Was
I mean, it was so easy to him, but he never had the mental headspace to make football a priority. It was all about partying. And so I think there's more the unknown. What if he could have gotten his crap together and actually stuck it out? Because, you know, when he got back in the AAF, you know, we were hoping, okay, maybe he's matured and it'd be interesting to see what he does. When he's in the Canadian League, it'll be interesting. The first time I ever watched Canadian Football League was when he was playing. And he just was a guy that could never get it back together. And I think that most people wrote him off. I think him coming out to say that football's behind him is more just to get his name back in the headlines a little bit.
That's an understatement.
The
good golfer, though.
John, is he?
Yeah.
Is he slow like you when he plays?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, probably. He's probably drunk.
Johnny Manziel, as good as he was, and of course, I mean, you know, the game against Alabama when he went on the road in Tuscaloosa the year he won the Heisman, it was pretty incredible, right? Yeah. But he never did anything against LSU. You know, LSU was able to bottle him up really the 2 years he was there. And my thing is that when you play the best teams, the better teams, you know, how do you show out? And yeah. I thought the fact, now granted, look, football, we know football is not a one-man sport. I mean, Patrick Mahomes was at Texas Tech and LSU throttled Texas Tech. And, you know, most people didn't even realize Patrick Mahomes played for Texas Tech, you know, and he's best player in the NFL now. But when you look at Tim Tebow, greatest SEC football player for a career at the time, Johnny Manziel just burst on the scene and literally, you know, puts A&M on the map for a couple years and was, you know, biggest star in the game for a couple years. And now we go to Joe Burrow, who just had the greatest single season that college football will ever see from an offensive player. I mean, I think his records probably will stay that way for a long time, if ever, unless they play more games or something. Didn't work out for Manziel, didn't work out for Tebow. Your concern, if any, when it comes to Burrow is what?
You know, I don't necessarily have it because he had the professional, you know, Tim Tebow was limited physically what he could do. He had the right mindset. You know, he worked as hard as anybody. His body did not allow him. His arm did not allow him to do things that everybody knew he couldn't do in the NFL. Johnny Manziel never had the work ethic. He never had the desire. I mean, even without – throw size out, you can start, you know, you can study film. You can, you know, be 100% about football, and he was never there. I think with Burrow, he's got the athletic ability. He's got the arm talent to do it. And he also works harder than anybody you've seen work in college football. I don't have a lot of doubt, if any, for Burrow going forward.
How about the report that we're getting coming out of Cincinnati that they're actually having to rein him in a little bit, that he's getting too far ahead in the playbook, that he's trying to get all the information as opposed to, like, you know, taking it in increments the way that they want to install.
That's what's made him successful to this point. You know, he's a guy that is coming. He's got a coacher's mentality. His dad was a coach. Both his brothers played. He knows what it takes to get there, and especially now that he got the guys around it. And also, he has a year of doing it under his belt. He knows the work it took to make LSU the team that they were this year. And I think that he's seeing that hard work comes with success, and he knows the recipe to do it in the NFL.
How about this? On Sports Shorts, which is every Saturday morning from 10 to noon right here on ESPN Radio, this past Saturday we had Trey Ledbetter, the owner of Southern Fundraising, was on our show, and he had just come back from a private autograph signing. There were four companies from around the country that brought tons of memorabilia. They did a private signing with Burrow and his agency and everything. They're going to do two or three more of these signings, private signings with companies from around the country. And it was in Ohio, and you go to a location. I mean, he literally wasn't even in the room. Like, he was looking through a glass window as Joe's signing I mean, it's ridiculous, you know, how they sequester these people and make it. The bottom line, though, he figured that he grossed about $1 million on the signing that they just did. Now, agent takes a cut, that your manager, this person, that person, you know, fees, da 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 da. So who knows what his portion was, but I mean, it was a $500,000 minimally was his portion on that, if not more, from one It was two days. It took them 2 days to sign all the stuff that they needed signed for these four companies from around the country. We'll have a lot of that memorabilia for auction at our Louisiana Sports Hall of Fame events. But $500,000 bucks easy for 2 days. And he's got a couple. He's got at least two or three more of these coming before he ever gets to training camp.
3 or 4 hours a day.
Probably more than that. You know, I mean, it's so many items.
That's just
plus,
insane.
It's all the specialty stuff. You know, you want Joe Burrow 9, that's one price. You want Joe Burrow 9, okay, 2019 Heisman Trophy winner, that's extra. You want 2000, you want national champion, that's extra. You know, that kind
of
stuff.
The amount of money that he's going to make before playing. And, you know, you're talking about they're having to pull him back. So, you know, he's got his people in line to worry about that. I think that he's just a true pro as far as what he knows what it takes to get where he's going. He knows the work it's going to take. And I got a lot of confidence in him.
Jacob Hester on his own show said the year after he won the, you know, it was part of the 07 national championship team with you, and then of course went on to his NFL career, you know, with appearances and this, that, and the other, he probably made around $100,000 that next year. Okay. Burrow did that in about 2 hours. All right. All totaled, what do you think you made in your career?
In signing autographs?
Appearances, autographs, that sort of thing, from your days at after LSU into the NFL with the Lions.
Maybe.
All totaled.
Maybe just under 10,000.
About just under 10,000.
Yeah, I mean, one was like 5,000, I think. Even if I got there, I have no clue. But, I mean, it was well under 10,000.
Right. Total for your career. Yeah. I mean, it's the haves and the have-nots. And to me, that's a little bit of the can of worms that the NCAA is going to be dealing with moving forward as they open up this, you know, players are able to make money and, you know, the likeness issues, you know, where they can sell a Joe Burrow jersey now at Tiger Stadium. Had he been player, how does he get a cut? How much of a, does he get a cut? Is there a cap? I mean, there's so many questions for the licensing issues. Is that autograph signings? Are you able to do that? Yeah. I mean, I don't know.
Well, right now,
to me, you're opening Pandora's box, the NCAA, by going down this path.
You're opening that box, but to me, I mean, the big concern, they're worried about using it recruiting. Well, you got a big Baton Rouge company that's going to go offer this kid that's coming in and give him $100,000. Well, let them be screwed if he sucks, because, right, you know, they're not always going to be good.
Absolutely.
There's a lot of recruits that have come in, five-star guys, and don't pan out. So to me, it's the grown-ups, so y'all want to go throw that money to get that kid to come here, and he never steps foot on the field. They're the ones that look stupid wasting all that money on a kid that's never going to play.
I agree with you, but they're never gonna make it okay to do that. Yeah. And we know some of those things happen, but they're never gonna make it okay to, you know, just open, you know, whatever, pay whatever you want to pay. You know, let the businesses take the risk. I mean,
if you put caps on it, and you can make this percentage, like the highest person on campus can make 20%. Well, then it's up to, you know, if Joe Burrow's the money he make is the same if they were selling the other jersey at the same rate. So then it's still on the players at that point.
I would love to know, had Joe Burrow had another year, okay, and decided to come back, a Joe Burrow, or even this year, you know, like, because at some point after the Texas game when Joe Burrow's star was just shooting off to the moon, had there been an ability for LSU to just print up Joe Burrow number 9 jerseys with his name on it and da-da-da-da-da, how much money would a Joe Burrow in the portal, the way the NCAA wants to do it, what would that amount of money have been like for him?
There was a tweet about it, and they showed 3 or 4 players on what their net worth would be off of Instagram or their social media platform. And I want to say that he was up there around, you know, close to $750,000 a promotion.
And that's from impressions and followers and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Not even merchandise.
That wasn't even merchandise. That was just what he could do off advertising on his Instagram.
Right. Just let him take advantage of the millions of followers he's got.
Yeah.
Wow. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. All right, we'll take a break on Hang with Hester, Ronnie Rantz, Richard Dick Dickson here with you. When we come back, we'll talk a little bit about a story, our first confirmed COVID Chinese virus divorce involving a sports figure. We'll talk about that when we return. Don't go anywhere. Plus, ask us. We'll get your questions in coming up in about 10 minutes. We'll do Ask Us. Anything you want, download the 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge app on your phone. Ask Richard, ask myself, ask Lloyd, ask Paul. We'll do our best to answer. We'll be back. Hang with Hester coming up next.
Hanging with Hester with Jacob Hester. In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 104.5ESPN.com.
Ne posso offrire un caffè.
Ne posso offrire un caffè.
Andiamo insieme da me. Non c'è.
Call Mr. Electric today for electrical repairs, upgrades, and installations.
I'm Jay Ducote. I grew up learning how to cook at LSU tailgate parties and right in my own backyard. And I created JD's Louisiana products to bring that Louisiana flavor to you at home for your backyard cookout. JD's Louisiana barbecue sauce, Louisiana molasses mustard, spicy and sweet barbecue rub, and more are available at your local supermarkets or by logging on to jducote.com/shop. Put in promo code CST for 25% off at checkout.
For over 50 years, customers have been heading to Happy Town for the Corvell Toyota experience. Get outstanding service with our complimentary loaner program when you buy your next vehicle at Corvell Toyota. So come on down to Happy Town. That's Corvell Toyota in Opelousas, Happy Town, USA.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
This is a house call. This is a test result. This is a prescription refill. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare. Start your virtual visit today at Ochsner Health.
If I built a van, it would do more than haul.
It would carry my entire business. I'd make it available in dozens. Make that thousands of configurations.
It would keep an eye on my fleet.
And an eye out for danger.
If I built a van, I'd make it available in diesel and gas. And I'd build it right here in South Carolina.
Introducing the all-new Sprinter, starting at $33,790. Built in the USA. Mercedes-Benz. Vans. Born to run.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is a local bank with a straightforward philosophy.
It's about doing the right thing for our customers.
Participating in our community with annual local fundraisers. Offering individual attention in a modern banking atmosphere with a trusted local company. Gulf Coast Bank invested in technology with a local touch, giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime.
We're building relationships through personal service as a bank that cares about you.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge, no matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111, your law firm for a lifetime.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
Means 3-1 great. Hangin' with Hester, with Jacob Hester. 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge. 11:30, The Tiger.
Welcome back to Hangin' with Hester. A couple more segments left to go in the show. Ronnie Rantz, Richard Dickson filling in for Jacob. We'll be back tomorrow. Right before we came on air, the hydraulics just gave out in my chair. Like, literally, like, I guess it said enough. Enough is enough.
This needs to be a new spring, maybe greased up. Like, I don't know.
I mean, I feel like Dorf on golf. Remember those videos from back in the day? Oh, my goodness. Anyway, couple segments to get to, and in our last segment, we'll have Ask Us. Just go to the 104.5 ESPN app. Get us any questions that you have for Richard, myself, Lori, the intern, or Paul O'Neill. We've got the first confirmed Corona divorce amongst star athletes, former SEC quarterback and NFL quarterback Jay Cutler. Not one of my favorite players, I might add. Played for the Bears. Did you play against him, huh?
Yeah.
It probably had to be a time where you...
Bears and Broncos, huh?
So Jay Cutler and his wife, Kristen Cavallari, who had that show, Very Cavallari. You remember her from The Hills. They've been together like 10 years or married for... They got divorced during the corona.
Well, what were you telling us? They got stuck in...
They were in Aruba together, Aruba? I think. And it was like, yeah, they got exiled in Aruba for about 2 months. And I think they had just had enough of seeing each other.
Well, you know,
when you're in close proximity,
people
like
were
that,
always joking about that, right? Like, two things are going to happen. Either there's going to be a baby boom in 9 months from the corona, March, April, May time, or there's also going to be a divorce boom, attorneys out there about 9 months from now.
A bunch of dead chickens, apparently.
You know, you think of their situation where. They were probably always traveling, never really stuck in the house for more than 2 or 3 days at a time together. They go to Aruba and get 2 months. They're like, this isn't what I thought it was.
You know, most people go to Aruba for 2 months to fix their marriage. Yeah. Theirs went kaput. And then you told me you've been stalking him on Instagram and all that. He's losing his mind a little bit?
Yeah, he finally got a hold of his own Instagram account. She was running it kind of for him, so he didn't want to be on it. And now that he has retired from the married life, he has a chicken coop in Tennessee. And there's a chicken coop killer on the loose, and he has been stalking it.
Cutler's been stalking his own chickens because somehow they've been killed.
I think it's funnier that you said now that they're divorced or going through a divorce, he took back over his Instagram account and he starts posting videos
he took
about
his own
shooting
life
chickens.
Back in his own hands.
Unbelievable. All right, so you can go check out Jay Cutler. You can watch him guard his chickens while he's going through
he's
a divorce.
He's posted up. He hasn't slept very much. He's got some night vision goggles and a gun. So he's up there trying to protect his chickens. He brought in a rooster. That didn't help. So he's kind of at his wit's end.
He's never been a Jay Cutler fan. Just never have.
This is making everybody's liking him because of this. It's made him very likable.
Heartbreak. Who does that to people, I guess? So we got some news out of LSU baseball that we'll get in before the break as well, and that is Alexandria's own from Senla, a 318 great, right? Matthew Beck, who's going to be back for his – senior year. This was supposed to be a senior year. Of course, he'll get it back. But Matthew Beck is going to wear the number 8 jersey. My chair just went down again. I'm getting lower and lower. Pretty soon, you're just going to see the Parrish County Line hat I have on. He's going to wear number 8. He'll be the first pitcher to wear the famed kind of number 8 jersey since Mikey Matuk started kind of passing it down over the years. It went Matuk. He handed it to Mason Katz. Mason Katz handed it to Alex Bregman, who handed it to Jake Fraley, who handed it to Cole Freeman, who gave it to Antoine Duplantis. Finally, Daniel Cabrera. This year now, Matthew Beck is getting the jersey. I think Paul Maneri's got a little more handprint on this one than the players do, because normally the players kind of hand it to the next guy. It's going to be weird seeing the big fella, 6'6", 6'7", whatever he is, wearing a number 8.
Well, it's got to be another first, too, that Beck has probably played with 2 or 3 other 8s.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, he's played with other 8s, and then now he gets to be the fourth one to wear.
This will be his fifth year coming up.
So he played with Duplantis, I know, and then, of course, Daniel Cabrera. So I don't know if there's
a third. And Cole Freeman. Cole Freeman, three of them.
Yeah, so he's been around for 3 8s while on the same team. Good for him. Obviously, he's a guy that Maneri probably wants to be pushed more into a leadership role, and it's got to have something to do with giving him the number.
Yeah, Matthew, quote from Paul Maneri, Matthew Beck absolutely epitomizes the values that characterize a number 8 tradition. He's been a tremendous relief pitcher for us throughout his career, and he's an honor student who's earned an LSU degree and has worked as a significant contributor to our community. So I think this is more they don't have an obvious stud. Like, there's no obvious Daniel Cabrera coming back next year. Like, who's the guy that's going to be in the middle of their lineup that's going to be the dude, the face of the offense? I don't think they know who that is yet. So because of that, go with the guy who's won all – I'm getting lower. It's getting lower. The chair's getting lower. All right, we got to take a break. Our final break, come back.
Fix it.
Ask us when we come return. The hydraulics will be back in the chair. Don't go anywhere.
Hangin' with Hester, with Jacob Hester. Yo, Jacob Hester here, and if you're a regular listener, then you know Richard's Honda is a great partner of ours. In times of crisis, you may still find yourself in need of vehicle service or need to purchase a new or used vehicle. Richard's Honda is still taking every step in following CDC guidelines to ensure the safety of their customer and staff while hoping to meet any vehicle need that you might have. Right now, they have 0% financing for 60 months on all 2019 models, plus the 2020 Pilot and the 2020 Odyssey, and no payments for 90 days. Visit RichardsHonda.com today.
Sports will be back.
But for now, we're all rooting for a different kind of hero.
Let's embody the best parts of sports.
Teamwork. Sacrifice.
Resilience.
One goal.
Together.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
To all of our heroes working on the front lines of this COVID-19 pandemic, your bravery and selflessness represent the very best of us, and we want to say thank you. I'm asking everyone around the state to join me in celebrating the heroism of our healthcare professionals on the 19th of every month at 1900 hours, that's 7 p.m. Write a note of appreciation, make plans to donate to charitable organizations, or say a prayer. To learn more, visit 19thanks.org. Thank you, and God bless.
When you want the best of Louisiana, you don't go to a superstore. We know what we like, and we like it local. Same goes for banking. As one of Louisiana's largest local banks, we offer homegrown services crafted around you. Gulf Coast Bank, the bank that cares about you.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
How many T-bills will Ronnie sell this hour? Hangin' with Hester. With Jacob Hester, Ronnie Rantz, and Richard Dickson. 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge. 1130 The Tiger.
Welcome back, everybody. Ronnie Rantz, Richard Dickson here with you, filling in for Jacob Hester. Just a couple more minutes left. Go to Ask Us on 1045 The ESPN app. We've got some questions to get in here with you. Has anyone ever Texas Rangered you with the high camera photo use? That's Ask Lloyd. Lloyd, if you listened to the show earlier, I got Texas Rangered by a bad photo online date thing.
I grew up in the era of the catfish, so I was well aware that that could be a possibility.
Nice advantage.
Yeah. Ask Richard, do you think you have a temper? Nookie with that question.
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Yeah. It can get there.
I guarantee your wife, she's a Chalmette girl, right?
She got family from Chalmette.
Oh, family. She's not from
there. She's not from Chalmette.
Okay, yeah, because the Chalmette people have tempers. Let's see. Somebody said to ask us, did Joel Davis make it back from his marathon weekend trip? Our Sports Shorts Radio co-host Joel Davis is back from his one-day vacation that he had to Mississippi. He made a big deal about it. Let's see. Ask us, how long is the Hester suspension for? Jake will be back tomorrow. No suspension. Did they have drug testing when I was at LSU? Yes, they did have drug testing. I don't know how they did it with football, but with us, they put a little card in your locker, which meant you had to go the next morning. And there was a guy that I played with, can't say his name. He tested so positive that when he got in trouble, Skip pulled him in his office and said, you actually tested so high that I got a phone call from the drug test person who gave you the test. And they said it was the highest drug test positive ever in the history of the school. Matter of fact, you were actually high when you took the test.
I was about to say, he was high when he took the test.
Yeah, what kind of drugs are he testing?
Shoot, you never know. Yeah. At LSU for football, they usually had a guy that was sitting out there on your way off the practice field.
Did they watch you go to the restroom?
Oh, they started grabbing you, and then you knew you had to go. Yeah. And a lot of guys freaked out. Would go sit in the hot tub for a while.
Stage fright's a real thing.
Tough, too. You can't leave till you get the job done.
He's Richard Dickson. I'm Ronnie Rantz. Hope everybody has a great week. Happy 4th of July this weekend. Hang with Hester. Jacob Hester will be back tomorrow in his regular time and place.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friends.